Hello, Summerfield Bank, Samantha speaking, how can I help you? Yes, I believe he's in the office today, would you like me to transfer you? Not a problem, just one moment please. Can I help you today? I see. Yes, we can do that for you. Is it a checking account or a savings account you're looking for? Perfect. Okay, well, we have a few options and I can go over those for you today. So my name's Samantha and I have the authorization to set up your new bank today. So can I just check before we begin, do you have any ID with you today? Just something with your photograph on it? A passport, a driving licence, something like that? Perfect, brilliant. I don't need that just yet, but I will be taking that from you shortly. Okay, so can I take a few details from you and then we can go into the details of exactly what it is you're looking for today? Brilliant, okay. So. Just bring up my screen here. Okay, so can I take your first name then please? And your surname. Do you have any previous surnames from marriage or? Okay. And how about any middle names? How do you spell that, please? Okay, brilliant. And your date of birth, please. Lovely. Okay, can I take the best contact telephone number for you, please? Okay. Is that your own personal number? Address. Is that .com? Fantastic. Okay, brilliant. Right. So, do you have that ID with you now? Yeah, driving license is absolutely perfect. I just need to take some details from this and make a quick copy as well. Fantastic. Okay. I just need to take your card, or your driving license number rather. Just, can you confirm your address for me as well? I'll just add that in. Yeah, that's the same as on here, so I'm just going to pop that into the computer. Brilliant. Thank you very much, you can have that back. Okay. But did you want any information on our savings account as well? Yeah, well, we've got a couple of options for savings, which I'll go into for you, but if you like, I'll just set up the standard checking and deposit account for now, and then I'll go into a little bit more detail about those for you. Okay, so just so you're aware, once I've set up the account, it does require a £1 minimum deposit. You're very welcome to put in more than that. And it takes between 7 to 14 days for your bank card to arrive. They are usually a little bit quicker than that, but that's sort of the average. If you do need to use your bank account before then, that's absolutely fine. If you just come back into the branch with your ID that I've used today, so your driving license, and then we have everything stored on here as well. I will also give you a temporary card today. So you can use that within the bank if you don't have your ID with you for whatever reason. We've still got your bank account details on there, which I'll pop those on for you now. Okay, so let's go ahead and set up your temporary card. So your temporary card is actually blue and silver, and when your actual one comes, you do get a choice of the colour or the design that you would like to have on there. So do you want to go ahead and choose that now? Brilliant, so I'll just pop that there for now. So we can choose from either red, blue, silver, or the Union Jack. Okay, good choice. Okay, so that's set up for you. So that should be with you within 7 to 14 days. If for any reason it doesn't turn up, just give us a call or nip into branch. Pin will also be sent, but that will be sent separately. We don't send out your card and your pin at the same time, just for security purposes. Usually within a day or two of each other. Yeah. Okay, so let me just set up your temporary card for now. I just want to pop in your account details. Set up, good to go for you. Okay, so home for you depositing in there today. £10 is absolutely fine. Yeah. You can set up direct debits to go in there as well, and I'll send out the information for you to be able to do that online, and you can do it on our app as well, so everything is really, really easy for you to access your money. And if you do get a little bit stuck, we have some online tutorials either on our website, or I do believe they've been shared to YouTube as well. So yeah, you can access those. Perfect. Okay, so that's your general depositing account. So things like your wages might go into there, and your standard direct debits might come out, like your usual bills, your phone, or rent, things like that. Okay. Can I just check, do you have that you own, or is it rented? Right, okay. So, in case you're aware or not, we do offer different mortgage deals as well. So, if you're interested at any point in looking for a new mortgage deal, you're very welcome to come to the bank. And as one of our customers now, you would get a preferential rate as well. That can be worth thousands, really, especially for a mortgage, because even just by a small marginal percentage, you know, over 25 or 30 years, if you get one of those, you're saving quite a lot of money. Yeah, you just give us a call whenever you're ready for that. That's fine. Okay, so you mentioned briefly that you might be interested in some savings. So we do have a couple of options for you today. So the first thing that we have got set up is just our day-to-day savings opportunity, which basically, there are similar things out there already, but this is our own personal one, and we work with your money because we know your money and we know your habits and your routines, and we know, we sort of get that familiar feeling from you and being able to use that for your account. So basically, what it does is at the end of every working day, it's around 10, between 10 p.m. and midnight, we look at your bank account. It's all electronically, so it's not somebody physically looking, so don't worry about that. And we round down, so we remove everything from your account and we start to put a little bit into your savings account. So for example, if at the end of the day you had £102.12, You can set up your parameters, so you can choose just like pennies, pounds or tens of pounds. And then we round it and we move it into a savings account. So that 12 pence we would move into a savings account, or if you would prefer, we can move the £2 and 12 pence. Mm-hmm. Or if you'd had £110 and 12 pence, we can move the £10, 12 pence. The idea being really, when it's such a minimal amount, like 12p, obviously it's not going to buy you very much nowadays, but as the saying goes, every penny counts. So if you did that every day for, you know, 365 days, then you're going to end up with quite a little bit of savings. And people sometimes start with just the penny saving, and then when they get a bit more comfortable and a bit more familiar, they might increase that to the pounds, and then sometimes even to the tens of pounds. Yeah, I think it's quite a nifty idea, and as I said, you don't even notice you're saving it, and then before you know it, you've suddenly got a nice little sort of cash pot at the end of it. So that's just our basic rate saver. Yeah, so it's just a handy way of you just sort of throw it. It's like throwing your change in a jar, you know, one of those old fashioned sort of things. Yeah, do you think that would be something that you might be interested in doing with this account? Yeah? Okay. Can set that up for you now, and it's really easy to access as well. It's not one of those, you know, you have to write off and explain why you need one. It's your money. As soon as you need to dip into it, it's there. But it's just sort of that mental mindful thing really, but you're aware that you're saving money as well, but if you need it, you can go and take it out. Absolutely. You know, I've had people tell me, you know, it's been enough for my car insurance, or when I suddenly had to pay, the washing machine's broken, I've got a bill for that. Without even realising to save that much money up, it's just nice to have that little saving pot there ready. Even if it doesn't cover all of it, it can cover a good chunk of it, or Christmas or something like that. Yeah, I think it's a great idea. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and set that up for you now. So do you think you'd be interested in doing the pennies or pounds saving? So the pennies one is obviously never going to be more than 99 pence. 99 pence would be the maximum that each day we would take out. And the pound one would never be more than £9. £9 would be the maximum. Maybe we can do the tens of pounds, but I don't, maybe you feel comfortable with that, but we would normally recommend the pennies, perhaps the pounds ones to begin with. Mm-hmm. If you wanted to, if you weren't so sure, there is the option on the app just to temporarily freeze that as well, and then you can reactivate it whenever you're ready. Yeah, so if you've got some big bills coming out and you think, oh, I can't really afford to do that right now, whatever reason, you can just put a freeze on, and then as soon as payday comes in, we can kick it in again, or whatever you want to do. It's all, it's your money, it's your free access. I'm going to go for the pounds. Yeah, that's great. Okay. Something else just to be aware of as well, if we can see that you've got some big bills coming out, the computer's really clever, so if it knows that you can't afford to pay those and you've forgotten, for example, to freeze it, then we won't take out the savings, we'll know. Yeah, we don't want you getting into debt or anything. Brilliant. Okay, I'll throw that for you now. So that is all set up for you now. Are you interested in any of our other more long-term savings accounts at the moment, or any of our mortgages, credit cards, or anything else like that? No, you don't have to. Well, if you're not sure, you can always take some information away with you, some of our leaflets, and have a read through, and there's lots more information on our websites as well. And if you do decide it's something that you might be interested in the future, then you're very welcome to either call back into the store in the branch and we'll help you set that up, or you can make a quick phone call and go from there. Mm-hmm. Perfect. Okay, so you have your ID back, you have your temporary card, and you're great to go now. Perfect. So thank you very much once again for choosing our bank. We really do appreciate your business. And if there's anything else I can help you with, please just call in and let me know. Otherwise, have yourself a great day. Okay, thanks very much. Thank you. Bye.